If you've got SaaS-based dish shelves and you're looking at external HBAs to connect to them, and you're thinking about doing something like TrueNAS or Unraid, then let's get ready to flash our LSI-branded 9200-8E external card. Links to these cards and the cables below that are most often used with them. Now, flashing to the P20 firmware is what we're going to be doing today. So we're going to start by creating a boot disk, then we're going to add the files that we need to it, and then we're going to go through the process of actually flashing it. At the end of this, you should have a very capable card that can support a number of drive shelves and a ton of disks. Let's jump in. First, we'll start off by going to the Rufus.ie website. You can download the Rufus portable executable here. Next, we need to download the 9200-8E package P20 IT firmware. This will be linked below. If you scroll down to the bottom, you'll be presented with the agreement box, and you can select that and download the firmware. And if you're interested in the technical specifications of your card, its capacities and capabilities, make sure to check out the spec sheet that I'll link also. Create a FreeDOS boot disk. Simply select FreeDOS from the dropdown for boot selection. Now click Start and write to your USB boot drive. While that's going on, we're going to go ahead and extract this. So now that this is done, go ahead and click Close. Open up in a new window. I like to create a folder here, so we'll create a folder and just call this 9200. Inside the 9200 folder, we're going to put in all of the things that we need to. So grab from the firmware folder, inside this, the IT mode flasher. Grab the SAS to flash executable. Put it in there for the DOS, and also grab the SAS to flash MPT BIOS and SAS2 ROMs and put them in the folder as well. Go ahead, take your drive. After you eject it, and let's go to the server. Okay, so we're starting up the server here. It's got two cards in it, so we're going to run a command to isolate one of the cards that we're going to flash, and we're going to get some information off of it before we go forward. During the boot process, you'll be presented with a screen, whatever kind of system you're on. I recommend running in BIOS mode for flashing instead of UEFI. It's going to make things just a lot easier for you. So I just have to hit the F11 key to invoke the boot menu. Now I'm going to select the USB in, again, BIOS mode, not UEFI mode. Okay. So now that we're in here, type dir really quick, and it's going to list out your folders and your files that you have there. So we're going to cd to the 9200 folder, and then we're going to do a directory listing again. So we can see that we've got the ROM, the bin, and the flasher right here. So the first thing that we're going to do is sas2flash.exe. We're going to set list all as the first command. And this is going to show us all of the connected controllers that we have. If you have more than one controller, you have to do this step. If you do not have more than one controller, then you can skip this step. I have an internal and an external in the server, again, connected to an MD1000, a DS4246, and also connected to the backplane of the SC846, housing roughly half a pebibyte. Okay, so I can see my two cards listed. They're both of one is a 2008 type and the other is a 2308 type. So the 2308 is already flashed to the latest firmware and it does not have a boot image. Whereas the 2008 is an older firmware at 18 and that's what we're going to be flashing to the P20 instance. So we can see that we've got different PCIe addresses and this is the important part, the number over here. So we're going to be working with number 0. So the next thing that I'm going to do is press the up and backspace here, and I'm going to do C, and I'm going to do 0, and I'm going to do list. And this is going to pull the information off that particular card. So you can see the SAS address here. This is an important thing that you want to make sure you have for any of the SAS cards that you're ever flashing. While it is currently running in IT mode, we can see here, it is also that firmware version 18, which is pretty old. So let's go ahead and do the command here to go ahead and flash and update this next and use the C again in 0, O, and E, and 6. And so we're erasing that card's memory right now. Make sure after you start this step that you do not power down your device. And the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to O again, and then we're going to F, and we're going to put in the bin. So actually, I'm going to hold on a second here. Okay, so we can see that the bin and the ROM. Now, I'm not going to flash the ROM because I'm never going to be booting from a device that's connected to this. If you want to, you can append it. I'll show you how to do that here. And the first one that we want to enter in is the 9200-8E.bin. If you wanted to enter in the BIOS boot, you would type B and mptsas2.rom. But I don't want to flash that because I'll never be using that. So, and it slows down your boot time somewhat. So this is all that we need to do. Again, the C0 important for me because I'm selecting that particular card that I'm flashing this bin to. Okay, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go back and we're going to do the list all again and make sure that we can see the card. Okay, great. So we can see that we're now up to the latest firmware, which is appropriate here. And also, we've got the card here with no boot image. Perfect. There's one last thing that we want to do here, and we're going to C0 and list, and we're going to see if it's got the SAS address. Perfect. It does. After this is done, all you have to do is reboot, and you now have an HBA in IT mode on the P20 firmware. This is great for your LSI SAS 2008-based cards, like the 9200-8E, which is useful for connecting and daisy-chaining a bunch of different disk shelves off of.
So now that you've got your flashed HBA, why don't you learn more about what you can attach it to with the video right here talking about the DS4246, an excellent drive shelf.